Hello everyone. Today I'm going to talk about three-dimensional modeling of nanomaterials from two-dimensional STM images acquired along a single viewing direction. In this regard, firstly, I'm going to talk about three-dimensional characterization by electron microscopy. Then I will explain STM quantification and relaxation studies by molecular dynamic simulations. Then I will show the three-dimensional characterization of supported gold nanoparticles at high temperatures, and I will conclude my presentation. Three-dimensional characterization of nanomaterials has great importance since there is a direct relationship between the properties and the structure. One of the most powerful and common three-dimensional structural characterization methods is electron tomography. For the tomography, a tilt series of STM images are acquired at different angles. Then this tilt series is used as an input for the reconstruction algorithm, and three-dimensional reconstruction of a nanostructure is obtained. However, tomography is not always applicable since it requires multiple exposures along with different directions. For instance, if we are studying the structural evolution of nanoparticles under gaseous environment, or if we are analyzing damage mechanism, or if we are studying the dynamics of extremely small nanoclusters, or two-dimensional structures in which tilting is not possible, we need to retrieve the three-dimensional structure from a single viewing direction. So as an alternative method, atom counting is combined with relaxation studies to obtain the three-dimensional model. For the validation, this reconstruction is compared with the high-resolution electron tomography from different slices. According to the total number of atoms at each slice, it can be seen that there is a great match between these two methods. And this shows the reliability of the alternative approach. On the other hand, it is still a challenging problem to obtain the three-dimensional model by this method, especially when there is no prior information. Here you can see the different possible input structures based on this STM image. And these different initial atomic configurations lead to different relaxed structures because the relaxation procedure by molecular dynamic simulations may easily end up in local energy minimum. So, to overcome these limitations, we focused on the optimization of the molecular dynamics initialization step. And we applied this method to gold nanoparticle on an oxide support during in-situ heating. It's known that supported gold nanoparticles are extensively used as a catalyst, and their catalytic performance directly depends on their size, surface area, surface facets, and interface parameter. This means that their catalytic performance directly depends on their three-dimensional structures at elevated temperatures. However, since electron tomography is not feasible for this system, we need to retrieve the three-dimensional structures from single viewing direction. In this respect, high-angle annular dark field scanning transmission electron microscopy allows a valuable method. The schematic view of the STM is shown here. In STM, an electron beam is focused on the specimen and the scattered electrons from the specimen are collected on annular detector, which results in incoherent imaging. An incoherent image changes with respect to atomic number and thickness. And because of their thickness dependency, these images are suitable for a quantitative interpretation. However, before quantification, the experimental distortions of each time frame is corrected by image restoration, which is going to be explained by Thomas Frederick later today. Then the restored time frames at each temperature are averaged after rigid and non-rigid registration. This step allows us to determine the atomic column positions precisely. After correct post-processing of STM images, the observed peaks in the STM image can be modeled as a superposition of Gaussian functions by using the statistical parameter estimation theory. Then, from the volume under Gaussian peak, the scattering cross-section value is estimated which gives the total number of atoms at each atomic column. For the quantification, STATSTEM is used, which was developed by Annick Debugger. Here you can see an averaged image of supported gold nanoparticles. In the statistical analysis, firstly, the atomic columns are modeled as Gaussian function. From the model, we estimate the scattering cross-sections. In an ideal situation for atom counting, we would have discrete peaks in the histogram. And each component here would correspond to a set of atomic columns having the same number of atoms in it. For example, the third component here corresponds to three atoms in the atomic column, which are colored as light blue in the image. However, due to the experimental noise in practice, the components are smeared out, which makes a visual interpretation impossible. Therefore, to determine the number of components and their locations, we use Gaussian mixture model and order selection criterion. This order selection criterion gives the statistically significant component, usually at a local minimum. For example, if the local minimum value is 11, the total number of atoms in a column varies from 1 to 11. And in this manner, we can estimate the total number of atoms at each atomic column. However, there is not always one ICR minimum value, and selecting a different ICR minimum directly affects the counting results. Therefore, a validation step is required to select the correct ICR value. For this purpose, simulation-based atom counting method is used. In the simulation-based atom counting, the validity of the results is confirmed with the simulated values. To make an experimental estimations comparable with the simulated values, these scattering cross-section values firstly plotted. Then to obtain the reference scattering cross-section values, multi-slice simulations is used by Multam software, which was developed by Ivan Lobato. In multi-slice simulations, the three-dimensional atomic potential of specimen is divided into many slices along beam propagation direction. As such, each slice only modifies the phase of the electron wave. Then from the simulations, the reference scattering cross-section values with respect to thickness are obtained. During the simulations, the frozen funnel model is used for the specimen electron interaction and microscope parameters are applied. But in addition to these, the temperature effect is also considered. It's known that as the temperature increases, the thermal vibration of atoms increases as well. And since we studied the nanoparticle under heating environment, it's important to consider the temperature effect during the simulations by calculating the theoretical bipolar factor and root mean square deviation of gold atoms with respect to their ideal positions. Moreover, in reality, the detector surface is not homogeneous, which can also be seen in the radial distribution graph here. Therefore, to make the multi-slice simulations realistic and to increase the accuracy, the non-homogeneous experimental detector surface is also taken into consideration. Here, you can see the detector sensitivity and temperature effect on the simulated reference scattering cross-section values. For example, without considering the non-homogeneous detector surface and temperature effect, the specified scattering cross-section would correspond to around 18 components. On the other hand, it corresponds to 20 component numbers now, which decreases, so considering the temperature effect and detector sensitivity, decreases the atom counting error by around 2 atoms per atomic column. And if we go back to the order selection criterion, when we select the ICR minimum at 11, an excellent match is obtained between the simulated and experimental scattering cross-section values, which validates our atom counting results. So now we estimated the total number of atoms at each atomic column. Then by placing the atoms symmetrically based on crystalline structure and stone axis, we can obtain an initial model of gold nanoparticles. Then to obtain the final structure, the nanoparticle is relaxed by molecular dynamics simulations with embedded atom model. Modeling the unsupported nanoparticles makes the simulation simple, as I showed in the previous slide. However, the presence of the support affects the particle morphology under a catalytic environment. Therefore, for the relaxation studies of the gold nanoparticle, cerium dioxide substrate is created according to the fluoride structure. And the interaction between the support and the particle is defined by Lennard-Jones potential. If we compare the final shape of the nanoparticle with and without substrate, we can see that the nanoparticle without substrate has more roundish shape after the relaxation. And this leads to increase 12 coordinated atoms in the structure. Also, according to this figure, we can see that the relaxation with substrate allows more 100 facets. And this is important for the catalytic purposes because this facet is one of the possible absorption sites of the gold nanoparticle. So, three-dimensional structures of the gold nanoparticle is obtained at different temperatures. Further results about the structural changes of the supported gold nanoparticle under heating environment will be explained in detail by Pei Liu tomorrow. In conclusion, the three-dimensional reconstruction of nanoparticles through the combination of simulation-based atom counting and structural relaxation is a reliable method if there is enough prior information. And this method is applicable for the three-dimensional characterization of nanoparticles under both static and real conditions. However, it is still a challenging problem to obtain the complete three-dimensional model of asymmetrical nanomaterials if there is no prior information, since the different initial atomic configuration leads to different relaxed structures. Many thanks for listening, and I will be grateful to answer your questions.